Well, after a very quiet start to the day, things are starting to really become more active, especially as we head throughout the next couple of hours. We have a very strong system that is moving through parts of Tennessee and now approaching western North Carolina, northeast Georgia, and even into parts of the upstate as of right now. We do have a tornado watch in place for parts of western North Carolina and a severe thunderstorm watch in parts of the upstate and northeast Georgia. So as we take an even closer look in, few severe thunderstorm warnings starting to pop on up, including parts of Haywood County as well as Buncombe County as those storms start to roll on through western North Carolina. A lot of lightning is associated with it. And what I am keeping a close eye on are some of these storms out ahead of the main line. These are ones that we need to watch very closely over the next couple of hours. They are very strong storms. They're moving primarily to the east as of right now. And over the next couple of hours, we're going to continue to see this coverage really begin to ramp on up. Looking at the severe weather threat, we are in a high severe weather threat, even higher conditions a little bit further towards our north. So this means that potential for strong to severe storms developing, and we can't completely rule out that potential for a brief isolated spin up tornado. So as we time things out over the next couple of hours, that line starts to work its way across the mountains. We need to watch this closely. Depending on how well it actually holds together, moving across the mountains will depict how much coverage we see as we head towards later this evening, so 5-6 o'clock. But as of right now, with our high resolution model that does in fact get updated every single hour, it is holding together some of these cells even through 6-7 o'clock, where we are seeing some of those more vibrant colors. That's where we need to watch closely for that potential for strong to severe storms developing. Damaging wind gusts are going to be the main impacts that we're watching throughout the next couple of hours. Then things will start to settle down at least briefly once we get closer towards sunset. So we're looking at primarily just some scattered showers, a few thunderstorms still possible through this time frame. But even as we head towards 9, 10, 11 o'clock, we are still looking at that potential for a few lingering showers and yes, even a few thunderstorms possible, even as we head into late tonight, early tomorrow morning. Most of this activity will begin to settle on down once we're waking up Tuesday morning. But really the best time frame for seeing some of these strong to severe storms is really going to be from about 4 o'clock this afternoon through about 7, 8 o'clock. Once the sun sets, most of us are going to start to see quieter weather return. Still can't completely rule out that potential for seeing strong severe storms even sticking around later tonight. As we head on into tomorrow, though, things will finally settle on down. We're looking at nice quiet conditions Tuesday into Wednesday. So yes, we are going to get a little break from that activity. And then as we head into Thursday and Friday, more unsettled weather will return to the forecast. Temperatures take a brief drop by late week, but as you can see, they're back on the rise as we head on into the weekend and into early next week. But again, stay up to date with our weather team as we continue to watch these storms all evening long.